What's good, YouTube? And I'm back with another video. Now, if you haven't seen my previous story time, go ahead and check that out. It's already posted on my channel. But today we're gonna be doing a reaction. Two videos in a two-day, not even a two-day, like a seven-hour span. Wow, isn't that crazy? Probably 10-hour, but you know, I'm not good with numbers, especially when it comes to time, like tick tick. So anyway, let's go ahead and get into this new reaction video. Now today I'm going to be reacting to It's Elijah's new video, My Sneaky Link Was Almost 30. Oh my god, when I tell you, he keeps me intrigued. Now I was gonna watch this on my shift because I saw it on my YouTube feed, but I thought, why not experience it with you guys as well? You know, like, kill two. Like, I had nothing else to do for the rest of the day, so I might as well do it. And before we go ahead and dive on into this somewhat amazing, intriguing video, I feel like y'all are here and y'all are ready to dive on into this reaction, but you haven't hit that subscribe button yet, and that's a pretty big issue for Waylon. I'm gonna need you to go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And also, you might want to hit that like button as well and show some more support, like, and follow all of my socials. I have an Instagram, a Snapchat, and a TikTok. You might want to go check all those out. They'll be in the link down below. And also, make sure you hit that notification bell after you hit that little red subscribe button so you never miss when I post a new video. You do not want to miss these bangers dropping all 2022 and beyond. Trust me, be the first one who experienced this. Be the first one who experiences me rise to famous. Now, anyway, without a set out of the way, I said we go ahead and get into this reaction video. Let's do it. You might want to listen. Already did that too.
Honey, you reeled me in. It's my swipe right. Yes, I did. Now, when I
I'm trying to fix y'all can see me. They're gonna reach out, they're not gonna hesitate, they're not gonna wait forever. You know, the younger boys, they be having any pride, they don't want to message you too soon, they be trying to keep cute and all that. Baby, no, message me, let me know that you want it. Now, I was saying, not even 5 minutes after we met, I just get a message from this young man. So when I opened the message, he said, hey, how are you? And I was just a little flabbergasted and perplexed. I'm like, this is different. I'm not used to this gentleman talk and, you know, people being polite when they reach out to me. You know what I'm saying? People around my age normally give like, yo, what's up? What you on? What you trying to do? Trying to link? That type of stuff. But he was giving a different type of energy. And I think I was kind of here for it, honey. Not going to lie to you. So I replied and I said, I'm feeling yourself. He said, better now that I'm talking to you. I said, woohoo.
Hoping the outcome would be of us having having, you know, a conversation. Well, honestly, I feel like I've been burying this side of myself for the longest. Now, I know what he meant when he said burying this part of himself for the longest, but, you know, I had to act clueless, and I had to, you know, really get the actual detailed answer out of him. I'm like, what do you mean by that? What side of you are you burying? He proceeded to tell me that he's been DL since high school. I said, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Hold on. Pause. Take a break. Huh? You're 28 years old by now. You get to high school like 14, 15, 16. Oh, wow, it's been a little minute, hasn't it? So I asked him, I was like, so have you been with guys before? Like, have you done anything, or have you just known that you're attracted to men? Oh, yeah, I definitely fucked with a few boys already, but it's been on the low. So when you say you fucked with a few boys, does that just mean you tried to, you know, get into the things that they have in the back of the front, or you've actually tried to, like, cuff them and talk to them and be in relationships and stuff like that? Both?
Oh.
Okay. Now, before I ask you the question, you kind of definitely would have been asking. I wanted to know, baby. I want to know all the information, all the facts, and to have my information together. He proceeded to tell me that he was very, like, impressed by how mature I was and how well I spoke. He said he was more so hesitant of talking to somebody that was my age because he thought that I would be, like, more so immature. So I guess he was pleasantly surprised, and he proceeded to tell me, like, I fuck with your vibe, like, you're funny, like, this is just, you know, it's clicking. So he says that, and I'm like, you know what, I have to say something back. I have to compliment him and say something that I'm impressed with, even though there's no, well, no, I was impressed with a lot. I told him, well, I'm impressed with, like, how you're handling me and how you're being a gentleman and how you're talking to me, like, you know, trying to actually get to know me, not just, you know, do the nasty, even though I don't know if that's what your intentions are. And it's like he's actually, like, listening to me, like, inquiring, asking more questions, trying to go more in-depth, like, having kind of deeper conversations, I guess. And it's like, it was topics that I've talked to other DL boys about in the past, but it's like, with him talking to him, it was just something more in-depth about it. Like, I don't know how to explain it. So after we pretty much gave each other a compliment session, if you will, we got back to me. So what were you hoping to get out of this? I don't know, man. Initially, I thought, you know, maybe just a sneaky link type. But after talking to you, I think, like, this maybe could go somewhere. Yes!
Oh!
Absolutely! Sharing your feelings and being honest with people that you like. Oh, my goodness. This is not something that I'm typically used to from any man. This may be the lane that I need to stick with. The older men, the way that they talk, and how mature they are, and how they just express their feeling. Maybe not all of them are like this, but if he was, I was like, I love this. This is what I need to stick with from now on. So he then reciprocated that same question to me. He asked, what was I hoping to get out of this? I didn't really have anything in mind. I was down for whatever you were down for. Now, in my head, I'm starting to get a little bit scared because I was enjoying this conversation. He was giving kind of like boyfriend, husband material. But I'm like, is this realistic for me? I always tell y'all and express to y'all how I feel like I am not ready for a relationship. I'm not financially stable. I just don't think I'm mature enough to be able to handle someone else's emotions. I don't know, because I can't handle mine right now. My anger is right below the surface. I need therapy. Little things tick me off. I have habits that I just need to outgrow. I just feel like there's a lot about me that is not ready to be with someone full term. I need to work on myself first. You know what I'm saying? And then on top of that, you being 10 years apart, I'm not even really concerned about what other people are thinking, but where we are in our lives, how will that work? Will that mesh well together? Mind y'all, all this goes through my head. First conversation. Haven't seen the boy. Haven't linked up yet. And I'm just thinking about all of these things relationship-wise, and I'm just talking to you for the first time. This is crazy. But you know what? I was honest with him, and I proceeded to express my concerns, what I was having in my head. I asked him that, or I told him that, excuse me. Now, in response to my doubts, my questions, and my concerns, he proceeded to tell me, if you fall for someone, you fall for someone, you figure the rest of that shit out. If you fall for someone, you fall for them, and you figure the rest of it out. I like you. I like you. This is when I say, yeah, this might be fun. Now, y'all, I am not going to lie. I thoroughly enjoyed this phone conversation, if you will. It was a very different speed than I was used to. I think this is my thing. I think I'm supposed to, like, talk to, like, older gentlemen, because I feel like the younger ones, that's probably why we owe them so much, because I'm more mature, and I think I'm more mature, not just how I present myself, but I'm actually, like, more mature, so, like, dealing with, like, these little younger DL boys and their ways, that's why we owe it so much, because I'm, you know, older than, well, not older than, but, like, I don't know, wiser in maturity years, I don't know how you put it, but y'all get what I'm saying, hopefully. Like, girl, my cheeks were hurting from start to finish, from the time you reached out to me on Tinder, from the time we finished having that phone call, baby, I was just smiling, I was just blushing, I was just flattered, I was feeling butterflies. I'm like, this is not okay. Why is this happening to me? So then the conversation came up about linking, and I'm like, at this point, baby, we can do whatever you would like to do. You've won it. You've won it. You've earned it. You're worth it. Like, you look good. We had a good texting conversation, and you can talk on the phone, and it was entertaining, and I was into it, and you had me flattered and blushing and stuff like that. Now I'm more attracted to you, babe. So I was just to ask him, I was like, well, you said earlier that you could see this going somewhere, that you don't know, like,
what more you want, but you know that you want to go somewhere. Whatever you said, did you want to keep talking on the phone for a little bit, or did you want to like see me in person? How's that going? Like, where are you mentally with that? How are you doing? Oh, I want to see you for sure. Oh, baby, you don't have to tell me twice. When would you like for that to happen, love? I'm gonna go get you tonight. Tonight? Give me an hour. He said, okay. I went into my grandmother's room. Grandmother, I have a friend who wants to see me. Is it okay if I, you know, go with him for a little while? I'll check in with you and all that kind of stuff. Mind you, grandmother is half asleep. She really doesn't know what's going on. She's just like, You know when your parents or your grandparents are half asleep, so you ask them stuff, and then, you know, for certain they're gonna
sleep. If anybody knows it, it's me.
But I know she would have let me know anyway if she was fully up and functioning. So I'm preparing. I'm feeling the vibes and the mojo, girl. We didn't even talk about, like, if we're doing anything sexual or, like, what we're doing. But he just, like, said he could come get me and, like, talk about linking. So that's what we're going to do. I have my little cameras going. I have my little speaker, my tunes going. Listen to my little vibes. Play this girl trying to get into the vibe and feelings of it all.
Okay.
And we didn't talk about anything sexual, I douche. Because if he wanted to do something to me, I was going to let him. So I douched, I shaved a little bit in some areas that I felt like needed to, you know, shave down a little bit. I got the shower, I sing in my heart out to every single
Oh, time. Yeah, he's in it.
I was feeling that music. I was like, yes! But all of a sudden, I'm in the shower, you know, washing my pits in my private areas and whatnot. I realized something. Elijah, you've been catfished before. Have we not learned anything? Have we not learned to not repeat the same cycle?
Oh, yeah. I haven't reacted to that video, but yeah.
And they take pictures of like your actual face to match it with pictures of your profile and video to make sure that it adds up, and then you know they have a little blue check beside it. Some people don't have it, some people do. I do have it. So in my head, I'm like, he didn't want to get on FaceTime. His account isn't verified. He looked a lot younger than 28. I'm like, Elijah, let's go ahead and, you know, double check. Let's verify this information, because now I'm getting a little skeptical. The senses are starting to come back, girl. Because y'all know what the boy that catfished me, girl. He sold me the American Dream, too. He told me all this stuff that was going to happen, and I believed it. Ended up being a catfish. I'm like, you know what? We're not going to have that happen again. Now, immediately after I got out of the shower, before I could even, you know, dry myself off, I was going to text him. I was like, hey, can we FaceTime real quick? He texted back and said, why, what's wrong? So I was like, well, I've been in a situation where I've been catfished before, and I still like to see your face so that I know that this is the person that I'm actually going to link with. So he said he understood, and then he FaceTimed me. Now, y'all, mind you, when he answered, he had the phone this close to his face. I said, wait a minute. You're looking a little too good effortlessly. You know me, I'm not, you know, fresh as strawberry. The strawberry is cool. You know, I feel like I can play up my looks and whatever. So, you know, I'll put on, you know, a little earring, a little lip gloss, a little mascara, maybe something, you know. You get the boys feeling like mojo. Like, if I get on FaceTime with a boy, I'm going to have to get myself together just a little bit. But him, you can tell he didn't do shit. Like, you were naturally that fine. Yeah, baby, that's all I need. Give me a few more minutes, babe. I'm actually going to rush and go faster now because I'm excited. I want you to come soon. So as I'm finished, you know, getting ready and stuff like that, I'm just going to text him the address. Oh, if he has this now, I'm more, you know, hesitant with giving my grandma's address out now because these boys be dangerous. You never know who people really are. You never know who people are really crazy. And, you know, all these little horror stories and horror films that happen with people on dating apps and stuff like that. Don't want anything to happen to my grandmother. If something happens to me, tragic and sad, but at least it happened to me and not one of my loved ones. I didn't put them in that kind of situation. You know what I'm saying? So, of course, I put on my little grown, sexy, sneaky-link robe. Let me actually show y'all the robe that I'm speaking about, because I always tell y'all about my little robe. This is the robe that I wear to my sneaky-link shoe all. It, like, ties around my waist area very tight, too, so it really accentuates my curves that I do have. It's very short. It stops, like, mid-thigh, I believe. It's an extra small, too, because I'm an extra small as well. Very cute, small, and petite. And then you see the material, it's just giving grown and sexy, it's giving lingerie. So minutes go by, I'm waiting for him to come. I'm actually more excited than I think I've ever been for a sneaky one. I mean, I've been excited before when I knew I was out the window and what I was finally about to, you know, do the nasty, but this boy, I wasn't really sure what we're gonna do, you know, I wanted to do that. I was just more so excited to, like, you know, talk to him and see him in person and see if the vibe and the connection was there, you know, physically. So I get that outside test and the butterfly, not the good kind, the nervous kind. Then you get to build up in my stomach. Now, I'm not gonna lie to y'all, I was trying to be cute and sexy and seductive. Baby, it was cold as hell outside. It was cold. I was freezing my little buns off. But hey, y'all know beauty is pain. Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. So I proceed to leave my girl in this house and I walk a few houses down. As I'm walking, I can already see his car. He had a red charger. Wait a minute, a red charger. That's something that kind of gets my ears going. That's a cute car for a boy. I can already hear that he was playing some music. I heard like a little bass, you know, thumping through. I'm like, girl, oh shit, what happened? What did that mean? Did something happen? Oh my God. At this moment, I'm panicking. Everything is running through my head. I'm like, do I like look terrible? Do I stink or something? Can't stink because I just took a shower, but I never stink. You know, I just not one of those girls. I was just asking, I'm like, what's going on? Did I do something? No, you just look good. I won't expect you to wear like a robe. Now, just for y'all, it's like 3 something in the morning. It's late as hell. And obviously, the reason it took so long, the reason it was so late, is because, girl, you know, do she be a bit of a long process than you think? So I kept having to keep the time back, you know, telling him, you know, give me a few more minutes, baby. So he's asking me what I want to do. I'm like, baby, where the fuck could we go? You know, I don't think anything's really open. We can't really do anything serious, you know? So I threw up there. I was like, could we go back to your place, possibly? When I made that suggestion, he was like, are you sure that's something that you're comfortable with? The fact that you're asking me, am I comfortable with coming to your home, makes me a lot more comfortable. So absolutely. So he proceeds to take off and we head towards his home. Now in the car, we started to have small talk again. I didn't mention to him that I do like social media stuff, but I didn't want to go in depth. I kind of tried to switch the topic. I told y'all I don't like telling boys about, like, you know, me having a platform now and, like, you know, being known on TikTok a little bit. I don't like telling the boys that. So when he asked me, I kind of lied again. I told him, I was like, well, I just do like sponsorships and I do like little fashion pictures. I don't do that yet, but I feel like it's something that's believable if I tell a boy that. Like, they could look at me and be like, oh yeah, I see that happening. You know what I'm saying? Now, y'all, in the car, I'm trying to pay attention the whole time, but he's wearing these sweatpants and I'm just seeing something, you know, poke through and I'm just like, ooh, it looks kind of good, kind of thick, kind of thick. Y'all know I'm a sexual person. Y'all know that the hormones are there. I'm young, I'm horny. You know, it's normal. But, you know, sometimes everything does not have to be about sex. Everything does not have to be sexual. So I'm trying to stray away from looking at that print down there. But, baby, you're making it very difficult. You're making it very tough. You're making it very hard. And you're probably doing it on purpose. So fast forward, the car ride was cool. We kind of got to know a little bit more about each other. And we arrived at his home. Now, I don't know what I was expecting. He told me that he lived alone. He has his own place. So I'm thinking like a cute little apartment, something nice, grown and sexy. But no, y'all, he had like a whole ass townhouse. It was the nice, more modernized looking ones too. I said, oh, you got money. This skincare line must actually be doing something for your life. You know, everybody nowadays, they have their little small businesses that they're trying to start up or that they have. It's not really, you know, doing anything. But I'm like, okay, you must actually be doing something because this is not the, charger. The townhouse, you live by yourself, baby, you're winning right now. So we both proceed to get out the car, and when we got out the car, I wasn't expecting him to be so tall. Like, y'all know how y'all have those boys that look tall in their pictures but aren't that tall in person, or that tall to you in person, or you have those boys that look short on their pictures but in person they're taller. He looked a little bit shorter in his photos. I was expecting, you know, for him to be a skyscraper. So once we both kind of got out and met in the middle to like walk into his house, he was like, damn, I thought you was gonna be taller. Oh, how tall did you think I was gonna be? I don't know, I'm thinking like maybe like 5'8", 5'9". You kind of look tall in your pictures. Really? Was that an issue? I'm only like 5'5", 5'6". Nah, I like mine shorter.
Ooh!
What's yours? What's mine mean to you? Mine, I'm your girl. Don't get me started. So y'all, we walk in clean as hell, organized, had everything together. His kitchen, let me describe the home. So when we walked in, that townhouse was huge, big as hell. I'm like, oh my goodness. Like, it looked big on the outside, but you know how stuff looks big on the outside and then on the inside it sounds big. I think that's what it was going to give, honey. No, way bigger on the inside to me. Like, when you first enter, girl, it's a dining room on the side, and then it's the kitchen, and then it's the living room, and then all the way at the end is where the steps are. He had a full backyard with a fence. I'm like, you know how expensive this is? It's really starting to hit me that this man may be a little bit coined up. This man is really doing well for himself. And I'm enjoying this. This is not something I'm typically used to do. And I'm used to boys asking me, girl, what if they ask me for Uber? Then he asked me to cash at them. Girl, that just turns me off. I will block you. Don't ever, boys, if you're watching and you want to talk with me, don't ever fucking ask for me to cash at you, give me money, Uber you somewhere if we are not together. Like, even if y'all together, girl, I'm not doing it. I'm that cold, stingy bitch that you're going to hate. Yeah, I'm not generous. I'm not trying to, you know, do more for you than you do for me.
You're right.
It's not happening.
You're right.
Take advantage of me, honey. But yes, y'all, house was nice as fuck. That was another turn on, girl. Did start to get a little, you know, rock solid. Real tough. I'm like, what is this turn on? A man that has his own place, he has stuff together. He looks like this. Girl, 28 might not be the worst thing in the world. So once we get in, I'm kind of looking around, like, ooing and awing. Like, I'm just very impressed. drink, I can use some water or something like that. He went to his pantry, he was like, I have Gushers, I have Doritos, I have Chips Ahoy.
Oh!
Like, all these snacks, I'm just like, you're stocked up, aren't you? I'm living the dream. I'm like, something has to be off about you. Perfect right now. What is going on? I put some cookies and some Doritos, wouldn't sound too bad right about now. And he proceeded to pour them on my little plate, and he handed them to me, gave me a bottle of water as well. So we went to HBO Max, and we ended up watching this movie, Horrible Bosses. Yes, that's the movie. It's kind of like a stupid.
I love Horrible Bosses.
So we're watching that. I'm finishing up my snack. You know, I'm gargling down my water. I'm asking him to go to the bathroom. Oh, excuse me. I didn't ask him to go to the bathroom. I asked him where the bathroom was. Let me refresh. I don't have to ask him if man's permission to use the bathroom ever. So he told me where it is. I got up. I went to the restroom. The bathroom is nice as well. He kept it clean. Had candles in there. Had fresheners. Had little details and decorations on top of the toilet. I was like, this is a man for real. Wow, I've been missing out. Now, the reason I wanted to go to the bathroom, I wanted to check myself out a little bit more. Even though he hasn't insinuated anything sexual yet, I'm like, girl, we're probably close to it. And then y'all eating Doritos and cookies and stuff. Y'all know Doritos leave your breath smelling like terrible shit. So I'm trying to see if he has something like minty fresh that I could use, but he didn't. So I proceeded to come out the bathroom. I go back to the living room and I ask, I was like, do you have any mints or anything? He said, yeah. Then he got up and said, let me grab them for you. I'm like, no, I can get it. You're such a gentleman. Like, yo, this was just such a good experience. I'm like, this is really making me, like, warm and happy inside at how nice he is. Like, I'm already up, baby. I could have got, you know, the mints and stuff like that. You don't have to get up out of your comfort to go get something when I'm already closer to it. So fast forward, we figured the mint situation out. We sat back on the couch. Now, this time, I'm trying to get a little bit more closer to him, you know, kick my feet up. Because, girl, I want to suck your man meat. I want to give you the butt arc down. I want to make you reach the top of the mountain because, you know, you've done everything to earn it, babe. So as we're finishing up the movie, I start to kind of, you know, rub on his thigh, you know, trying to get it going, trying to get the physical attraction there. But to my displeasure, he proceeds to look at me with kind of like a side eye. My hand was on his thigh like this. He took my hand and moved it back to where I was. What's that problem? What's going on? Why don't you want this? I told you I feel like this could go somewhere else. I don't want to do that again.
Oh.
So we're not doing anything sexual, to be clear. And this time I actually said that out loud. I was like, you don't want to do anything at all. Like, you don't want no hand. You don't want to, you know, have it. Of course, you don't want to do nothing. He was like, nah, we got time.
Oh.
So I just wasted all of that time douching. And I won't say showering, girl. Y'all let me fresh. But I was all that time douching and shaving and putting myself thinking about something, you know, sensual and sexual with you. Granted, that's my fault for thinking that when you didn't say that, but that's just what I assumed that it would be. Oh my goodness. So y'all, literally nothing ended up happening. Well, sexual, that is. We actually did have like a good time. We had good conversations. We talked. We watched stuff. Now, fast forward, y'all, I actually had a good ass time. The only thing that we did do, I forgot to mention this, we did kiss a little bit. You know, we did kind of make out.
Oh.
Flip some tongues, if you will.
Okay.
And y'all know I don't do that, but this situation, it was giving that. It wasn't giving sneakily. It wasn't giving us just doing the nasty, baby. I need to touch your mouth. So time flies by, the sun is starting to come up, I'm getting sleepy, I'm like, girl, I gotta go home, I gotta log into my classes, even though I'm gonna go back to sleep anyway, girl, I still have to log into my classes and be present, girl, so they don't count me as sick and try to get me to go back in person. So I proceeded to tell him, I'm like, okay, I have to get home, I got school in the morning, this, that, the third. He was like, really? He was like, are you really gonna make it? Oh, baby, I'm virtual, I don't have to go in person, I don't have to physically, you know, go there, but, you know, I still need to be home, need some rest, and log into my classes and stuff. You can log in from your phone.
Oh.
Hey, you're really trying to get me to stay, aren't you? Oh my goodness. No, I need to be on my laptop and I need to go to sleep. I need to get some rest. I'm a little bit tired at this point. And he kept trying to, like, I don't know. I think he kept trying to get me to stay. I mean, he was telling me to stay. He was, because he kept finding loopholes. And I told him, like, school, he said, use your phone. I said, I'm tired. He's like, you can sleep here. Baby, no, I have to go back home to my grandmother. She's probably deep sleep, doesn't know that I'm out this long. So he finally gave in to take me home, girl. We weren't really talking or anything in the car, just listening to music. Because I was honestly, I was out of it because I was tired. I was dozing off in the passenger seat, not gonna lie to you. So we finally get to my grandma's home or the house that I told him to, you know, park at a couple houses down. He wakes me up, he kind of shakes me, girl. At this point, girl, I fell asleep hard. I was in a deep sleep, not gonna lie to you. I always get to sleep in the car. I don't know why. Ever since I was little, I always used to sleep in the car rather than at home. So when he wakes me up, he's like, we're here. And then he asked me, he was like, could I see you tomorrow? I told him I'm not sure because I have a trip coming up and then, you know, I got to pack and I have to do a whole lot of stuff to prepare. So it might be a couple of days, babe, not going to lie to you. Then he was like, okay, well, I'll just text you later. So I tried to leave the car and then he kind of brought me back in, reeling me in for a kiss.
Oh.
I'm so he's making me wait to do stuff with him sexually because he wants me to keep coming back. Not that that's the main thing. Like, I do actually like this man. But it's like, you know what you're doing. Like, you know you're
but like,
you know you're sexually attracted.
He's 30, though. He's 30. Like, that's low-key. That was one of the story times where I was actually, like, happy. Like, I was actually happy. Like, usually his story times, I'm either, like, just bored or sitting there. But, like, no, I was chasing the whole time because it's just, that's what I want. I want a relationship where stuff like that happens. But anyway, that's enough about me. This is his moment. I'm gonna let him shine the way he wants to. Anyway, guys, that wraps it up for this reaction. Hope you enjoyed my reaction, or if you enjoyed him, either way, I don't care. We both give and give. Now, anyway, that's it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you so much for watching.